good day to play Gorilla Tag. Oh, and there's a new message of the day. The launch bundle's going. Get me that right now! I'm here. So, as mentioned on the message of the day board, all three of these cosmetics will never be coming back. If you haven't already bought the launch bundle, then you have 7 days to buy it. And if you're still not sure about buying it, the 10,000 shiny rocks is worth it. If I was to purchase 5,000 from the ATM, it would cost $20, but the pack also costs $20, so you get all of this stuff and you get a 2x value. Get it while you still can. Based on the message of the day board, it seems that it will still be on Steam because there's some issues with buying it just removed on Meta platforms, which could mean there might be a new bundle already to replace it on Meta platforms. With the departure of the launch bundle, let's take a look at its history, and the history of the Gorilla Tag launch. On the 15th of December 2022, Gorilla Tag finally had its launch, off of the App Lab, but now onto the main quest store. With this new update came new cosmetics. When trying to buy an item from an older update that has the cosmetic set to zero, it does not let you. During the game's initial launch, the map was in its full stage. This update also came with a glitch with the branches that would make them invisible on some sides. And because every single tree in here, excluding Stump, is the same, just resized and scaled, it happened to every single tree. But this isn't a Glitch Hunters video. One of the main things that came with the Gorilla Tag launch was the new map. Clouds. People have had very mixed opinions about this map. Here's my friend for his opinion on the Clouds map.
I think this map is terrible because it's very big, but I just think it's like boring because yeah.
But why was this map hated on so much? It brought something new to Gorilla Tag, the Cloud, which allowed you to jump extremely high even without boost. It even brought these wind tunnels, which are used to surround the maps now so people don't escape the maps as easily. However, the map has had a history with being able to escape it. When the map was first launched, it was possible for you to get flung outside of the map when standing on here. However, in later updates, the force field of wind has gotten a lot stronger, preventing you from doing that. So what do you think of this map? Do you like it or not? Let me know in the comments.